We'll start this meeting at 6:01 PM. First, let's call the meeting to order. Roll call.
Mayor Vendano, present.
JJ Peña, present.
Oscar Salinas, present.
JJ Garza, present.
And John Anise here. Dr. Villa, do the clerk quorum.
Thank you, Mr. Alanis. Members of the audience, before we start our meeting, I would like to have a moment of silence for one of our students, 10th grader, Oscarín Villarreal, at Carter Early College High School. Thank you. This evening, we have Alisa Marie Garza. She's a fourth grade student at Evangelina Garza Elementary. She's the daughter of Jaime Garza Jr. and Grace Marrero, and older sister of Haley Cantu and Christian Cantu. Alisa is a GT student and has been a campus millionaire every year since second grade. Her goal for this year is to become a double millionaire. She participates in several UIL events and is part of the photography club. She enjoys reading and writing short stories on her free time. Her favorite hobby is creating videos for her YouTube channel. During the summer, she spends her time practicing twice a day for the TAAF swimming for the city of La Jolla and competes at the state level where she's ranked top 10. Her parents and family are extremely proud of the student and the person that she is, humble, responsible, and caring. They are proud of all her accomplishments and hope to see her do great things in the future. We also have Clarissa Reina. Clarissa Reina is a fourth grade student at Evangelina Garza Elementary, and they wanted to do the pledge together. She is the daughter of Roel Reina and Miriam Gutierrez, and sister to little brother Esteban Reina. Clarissa is an avid reader, enjoys reading books about horses, fairies, and superheroes. She has been a campus reading millionaire since she was in the second grade, and this year is close to achieving her 2 million word count goal. Clarissa is also a GT student and has been an active participant in her campus UIL for the last few years. This year, she placed seventh in the district UIL in spelling. As a third grader, Clarissa was invited to be part of the La Jolla ISD Poetry Cafe for her entry entitled Saturday. Her parents are very proud of her for her accomplishments as a student, but even more for being a self-giving, dedicated, and loving member of her family. This evening, we have Alisa Marie and Clarissa Reina, Alisa Marie Garza and Clarissa Reina, that will lead us for the pledge. Will everyone please stand?
To the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Great job, girls. You represented your campus well. Parents and members of the family, I see the grandma and the parents. Would you please stand and be recognized? Thank you.
Next, we have tax collector's report. Item number one, January 2016, tax collector's report.
Second.
A motion made second. Any questions? All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
All opposed? Motion passes. Next item, we have approval of minutes. Item number one, special call meeting, February 22nd, 2016.
Also moved.
Second. A motion made second. Any questions? All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
All opposed? Motion passes. Next, we have our superintendent's report.
On our superintendent's report, we'll start with our enrollment. We have 15,090 elementary students as of March the 1st, and 14,404 students, secondary students, for a total of 29,494 students. Tonight is a special evening. We have several recognitions, and we're really proud of our students and our staff members. And so I'm going to ask Mr. Peña and Mr. Salinas to please step forward as we recognize some of our students and staff. The first recognition is going to be recognition of Spelling Bee champions advancing to the regional Rio Grande Valley Spelling Bee competition. And we're very proud. I know they competed again this Saturday. And so we're going to take time to recognize these great, great spellers.
That is correct. Members of the audience, Dr. Benavides, and members of the board, La Joya ISD is very excited and very proud to have with us three Spelling Bee champions that will be advancing to the regional competition coming up, representing La Joya ISD. And so we're very excited for these three individuals, and we have them from distinct campuses.
It already happened. It happened Saturday.
On March 5th, that's correct,
yes.
And so we have Stephanie Moreno from Irene Garcia Middle School. We also have Jacqueline Ruiz from Chapa Elementary. And we have Ms. Laila Vega from Flores Elementary.
I know the person at the district level that organizes the Spelling Bee is Dr. Oliveira. So Dr. Oliveira, thank you for organizing this. And the coaches are Miriam Barrera. I don't know if Miriam Barrera is here. Coach to Stephanie. Debbie Garrett, coach to Jacqueline Reese. I don't know if the coaches are here. If they're here, I would like them to step forward. And David Loya, coach for Layla. One of the coaches is here. Great. Will the parents of these students please stand and be recognized? Thank you. You have bright young ladies with a bright future. Continue to encourage them to work on their spelling. For the record, Mr. Garcia, Joel Garcia, joined us at 6:08. Our next recognition is recognition of La Joya ISD students who participated in supporting, harnessing, inspiring, nurturing, and empowering, and it's a program called SHINE. The person in the district that worked on this is Mrs. Brenda Gonzalez Garcia, and so she's gonna explain this recognition to us.
Good afternoon, Board President, Mr. Alaniz, Dr. Benavides, and members of the community. My name is Brenda Garcia, and I'm the middle school math coordinator. Thank you for allowing us the opportunity to recognize our students who participate in the SHINE program, which does stand for Supporting, Harnessing, Inspiring, Nurturing, and Empowering program. The SHINE program was a 10-day academic enrichment program, which was held at three campuses, Dr. Sines Middle School, Trevino Middle School, and Salinas Middle School. Sixth grade girls at these three middle schools were mentored by our high school dance students, and the goal of the SHINE program was to improve the girls' mathematics scores and to spark their interest in mathematics by utilizing an innovative method of formal dance training integrated with math instruction. And with us today, we do have Dr. Reyes and we have Ms. Lopez, who are part of the Texas Graduate Center that helped with this initiative. So I would like to invite Ms. Lopez up.
Hello. President Alaniz, distinguished members of the board, Superintendent Benavides, and La Joya ISD community, thank you for your leadership and support in bringing SHINE for Girls Math Camp to La Joya ISD. And thank you to Dr. Trevino and Ms. Brenda Garcia, as well as Ms. Lucy Munoz for their continued support of this initiative, as well as other initiatives. Thank you. I have a brief presentation. Just get this ready. So I'm very excited to share our SHINE program with you today. As Ms. Garcia said, this program was targeted to middle school girls to improve their math scores as well as encourage them in the STEM field. Science, technology, and engineering and math are very important, but girls who take an interest in such subjects in middle school tend to drift to other interests in high school and college. So SHINE was set up to prevent this and keep girls interested in math. So what can we do to prevent this as well as programs like SHINE? We can involve girls in activities that encourage their participation, create opportunities for students to see connections and engage in real-world learning experiences, provide role models for girls, and inform and involve parents. And along with SHINE, La Jolla ISD has also approved a GEM camp, Girls Engage in Mathematics, for a third summer. So thank you, Board, for your continued support on that initiative as well. SHINE is a program that incorporates movement and dance to help girls learn math. The program works to empower young ladies with their confidence as well as their math skills to help them understand and embrace math. There are five pillars of SHINE. It's set up to support local youth in educational pursuits, to harness self-esteem and confidence on stage and in the classroom, inspire young women to pursue STEM fields, nurturing a love of mathematics, and empowering women across America. This is a national program. It's been initiated in five other states as well. SHINE for Girls, as Ms. Garcia said, met for 10 Saturdays at three different campuses, Sines Middle School, Treviño Middle School, and Salinas Middle School. They used dance and movement. We also had math concept tutoring, and they were mentored by teachers, college mentors, as well as La Jolla ISD high school students. We have some survey results. The girls were given a pre-test and a post-test, as well as a post-survey. 100% of the girls that participated reported an increase in math confidence as a result of the program. 90% reported a positive mindset or attitude on how they feel in and out of math class. And 90% of the participants met or exceeded the program's expectations. So we were very excited to report these wonderful, wonderful numbers. I'd like to share a brief video that highlights the girls as they participated in the program over the course of 10 Saturdays. Proud of all of the middle school girl participants as well as La Jolla ISD high school mentors. They did an amazing job So congratulations to all of our Shine girls. You all did an amazing, amazing job. Thank you.
Thank you, Mrs. Lopez. We're going to go ahead and continue with the recognition of the girls as well as our student mentors. From Dr. Science Middle School, we have Ana Chavez. Eunice Gonzalez. Darla Quiroz. Jaylen Munoz. Evelyn Villarreal. And our student mentors from La Jolla High School, we have Bernice Garay, Michelle Blanco, Marleth Garza. Our sixth grade counselor, our contact person at Dr. Science is Ms. Rubio, and the principal is Ms. Martinez, who wasn't able to join us tonight, so we do have Mr. Pena, who's here, so thank you, Mr. Pena. And our lead mentor wasn't able to attend either, but her name is Ms. Veronica Flores. You want to, yeah, first. All of them together? You want to do it by school first? Thank you. From Trevino Middle School, we have Ariana Barraza, Patricia Puente, and Kayla Torres. One of our student mentors that joined us tonight is from Juarez Lincoln High School. Her name is San Juana Castillo. Our lead mentor who wasn't able to join us is Ms. Sepulveda. Our sixth grade counselor was Ms. Espino. And then the principal, of course, is Mr. Garcia from Trevino Middle School. Ms. Lopez will be recognizing the school for Mr. Garcia. Can we have one more picture, please? Thank you. And from Salinas Middle School, we have Arleth Cayente and Crystal Andrade. Our lead mentor was Ms. Gutierrez. The sixth grade contact counselor was Ms. Esparza, and Dr. Uresti is a principal at Salinas Middle School.
If we could do one big group picture with all of you. Yeah. Brenda, you want to come join the picture?
Yes.
Thank you. Congratulations, girls. I'd like to ask all the parents from the girls who participated in Shine to please stand and be recognized. Muchas gracias por el apoyo que les dan a sus hijas. And I see two principals that I failed to recognize being here for their spellers. Mrs. Laura Lopez, principal at Chapa Elementary, thank you for supporting your speller. And Ms. Rosanelia Flores, principal at Flores Elementary, thank you for supporting your speller. Our next recognition is recognition for our Texas Social Worker of the Year. We're very, very proud of this honor. And she has been a social worker with us for 25 years. But Ms. Marina Abdullah, who is Executive Director for Student Services, is going to fully introduce her as she was named the 2016 Texas Social Worker of the Year at the Texas Social Workers Conference in Austin a couple of weeks ago. So, Ms. Abdullah.
Good evening, Board of Trustees, Superintendent, and members of the community. When I was asked to write a recommendation letter for Ms. Claudia Gonzalez, I quickly did it because I know what a great social worker she is. But I never thought, not because I don't know what kind of social worker she is, but for the state to be recognized as a social worker for the whole state of Texas was a great honor for her. So I just want to say congratulations again, Claudia. We're so proud of you. I wanted to take a minute to read the recommendation letter that I wrote for her. I write this letter of recommendation with the utmost respect and enthusiasm for Claudia Gonzalez. Here at La Jolla ISD, we are so proud and privileged to have such a hardworking, compassionate, and dedicated social worker as Mrs. Gonzalez. As the supervisor for the district social workers, I confidently say that Claudia Gonzalez stands out among the rest. They all go to her for advice and ideas. Consequently, when we are asked to mentor and train interns from colleges and universities, they are mostly assigned to Claudia Gonzalez. She does such an excellent job in training them that we have hired several of the interns on the completion of their certification. Last school year, La Jolla ISD opened up 3 central office positions to assist with our high school graduation rate. Knowing that all our high schools serve a very high-risk population, we needed to find the best people to help our students overcome all kinds of obstacles in order to help them graduate. We needed someone who was resourceful, creative, empathetic, and who would get the job done. Needless to say, we knew we had the best person for the job right here in our very own district, Claudia Gonzalez, and what a difference she has made leading the other two. In fact, under her leadership, our graduation rate improved, and we were able to make significant gains with our limited English proficient and special needs populations, who are the most challenging. We couldn't have selected anyone better. Mrs. Gonzalez also led the charge to advocate for the reclassification of the district's social worker salaries. She spoke to anyone who could help their cause and succeeded in getting them an increase in pay with the approval of the Board of Trustees. And this was several years back, not recently. Okay, and then among other roles and accomplishments are the following. She serves on committees to update job descriptions and job performance evaluation forms for social workers, various task forces that rely on her expertise on student and family factors. She presents to the social work classes at the local university. She attends state and national social work conferences, even at her own expense. And she was even instrumental in the creation of a social work class at the university. Because of this and so much more, I proudly and vehemently write this letter of recommendation for Claudia Gonzalez. For her admirable 25 years in the social work profession, for her dedication to students and parents, for her whatever it takes attitude to help students feel good about themselves and succeed, and for the caring, nurturing human being that she deserves the 2016 Texas School Social Worker of the Year Award. Because to La Jolla ISD, she is the Social Worker of the Year every year.
Congratulations, Claudia. We're very proud of you. Thank you for your work. I don't know if any of her members of the family are here. Our next recognition is recognition of Dr. Francisco Rivera, we call him Frank, Executive Director for Curriculum and Evaluation, for receiving the Texas Statewide Network of Assessment Professionals Region 1 Award. Dr. Rivera was recognized by the Texas Statewide Network of Assessment Professionals for his dedicated service and outstanding accomplishments in assessments at the Texas Assessment Conference in Austin, Texas. Dr. Rivera was nominated for this award for his willingness to help colleagues in the Rio Grande Valley and throughout the state with testing and accountability issues. Dr. Rivera is one of two Region 1 members of the Accountability Technical Advisory Committee, a state-level committee that studies student assessment and accountability issues to provide information and recommendations in these areas to the Commissioner of Education. And knowing Frank, we could have no one better in this committee. So thank you, Frank, for the work you do for all of us in the area of assessment. I see Frank's wife and daughter here, and Claudia, I don't know if any of your family members are here, but if Claudia's family members and Frank's family members, could you please stand? Because it takes a supportive family. Thank you. That concludes the recognitions for this evening. Thank you, Mr. Salinas and Mr. Pena. The last item under the superintendent's report is the Region 1 Education Service Center Board elections. Each trustee will get their ballot and take time to vote. For the record, Ms. Espy Ochoa joined us at 6:29 p.m. This concludes the superintendent's report.
Thank you, Doc. Next item, we have no discussion items. Next item we have is public comments. We have two public comments. First one is Jose Hansen. You can proceed to the podium, sir. Am I pronouncing that right, Hansen? Or?
Right here.
Okay, you have 3 minutes, sir.
Okay.
You can go ahead and start right now.
The questions I have is with the renewable energy power purchase. In light of some new legislation that's changing, that's already here at the Willacy County and Cameron County, that will be here in Hidalgo County pretty soon, could change the whole structuring of the benefits of cost of putting in a solar system in this school district, and that was what I wanted to bring up.
Okay.
This is Brooks. This is also my colleague.
We're just here to see what specific, I know we're kind of late to the game in understanding this process, but it was interesting to understand what the RFP vote is for today for the solar, if it's a bid review or a finalization of the project for the district.
You understand that the board does not have to answer any questions, right?
Okay. Mr. Anson, you've signed up for public comment, and that gives the opportunity for the public to make comments, not necessarily ask questions of the board.
Oh, okay.
So if you have any questions that you have or information you may need, I would welcome you to come in tomorrow morning during the office of business hours, and you can request whatever information the district can provide to you.
Okay, thank you.
And if you need that contact information, we can provide that to you.
Okay, thanks.
Thank you, sir. Next, we have Rolando Herrera II. Mr. Herrera, you understand you have 3 minutes? You can start right now, sir.
Good evening, members of the board and Dr. Benavides. On behalf of La Jolla Early College High School, I, Rolando Herrera II, am here to represent the student body of La Jolla Early College High School. In 2013, the newly founded early college known as La Jolla Early College High School came to our district. Over the span of 3 years, the school has made an impact to over 360 students in our campus. As we, the students, excel through the school's wonderful opportunities, we transform from being students to being a family. Despite all of our different aspects and beliefs, we believe and come together as one to show that we care for one another's opinions and beliefs. Through the course of the school's existence and the aid of the administration and staff, we, the students, have become effective leaders, not only in our school, but also in our communities. La Jolla Early College is a branch school of La Jolla High School, and through which students on our campus are allowed to take part of extracurricular activities such as sports, fine arts, UIL, and over 20 organizations throughout La Jolla High School, while taking college and advanced placement courses through our school. Our school's goal is to obtain an associate's degree in interdisciplinary studies at the end of our senior year. While this is a grand opportunity and program where students excel in showing their intellectuality and personality, we were informed that our school will be closing its doors to incoming freshmen and phasing out our early college program. We, the students, as well as parents, are here to voice our concerns, to show that we want this amazing program to stay alive. Transforming lives, transforming communities is our proud district's motto. In phasing out our school, 120 incoming freshmen won't be able to experience this experience. 120 leaders won't be able to shine in our community. The district's vision is educational excellence, the right of every student. La Jolla Early College High School, home to over 360 future leaders of the world. So why stop this transformation? Why stop the future leaders? Why deny the future generation of La Jolla Early College High School their right to an excellent education? Thank you for your time and attention for this topic.
Thank you, sir. And our final one for today, we got another one right now, is Myra Garza. Ms. Garza, you have 3 minutes, you can start right now.
Buenas tardes. Como padre de un estudiante de La Jolla Early College, ellos quieren saber por qué van a cerrar la escuela. Si es acaso porque van a hacer el water park y no tienen con qué completar el dinero ese, o porque el contratista ya no le ocupa más dinero. ¿Cuál es el problema entonces? Estos niños son excelentes estudiantes. Vas a esa escuela, esos niños están sentados haciendo su trabajo. No como las otras escuelas, que todos están corriendo y haciendo lo que no deben de hacer. O sea, esos niños, ¿por qué les van a cerrar la escuela? Cuando los de 9 estén en 12 ¿qué es lo que va a pasar? ¿Van a ser nada más 90 estudiantes? Y lo de, they're gonna miss out on the whole high school experience. Why? Why? Why start something and not finish it? What are you gonna do with them? You're just gonna leave them there? I don't think this is right, and I'm hoping to get more parents coming to here. A lot of parents were hoping to have their eighth grade students go into the program, and now they can't because we're being greedy. That's all I have to say right now. I'll go ahead and call the media. Thank you.
Okay, next we have consent agenda with item number 6 under bids being pulled out. Need a motion?
Make a motion.
Second.
I have a motion made a second. Any questions? All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
All opposed? Motion carries. Next item under contracts, discussion and possible action on memorandum of understanding with Hidalgo County Head Start.
Also move.
Second. I have a motion made a second. Any questions? All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
All opposed? Motion passes. Item number 5 under business and finance, authorization to solicit proposals under the job order contract construction procurement methods for repairs, renovations, and and alterations to district facilities.
Also move.
Second.
Have a motion by second. Any questions? All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
All opposed? Motion passes. Let me go back to item number 6 under bids, procurement of reconditioned school buses through TIPS purchasing co-op.
Mr. Ramirez, you're here. I guess a board member pulled out the item?
No, I pulled it out because it was in consent. And since we had several questions, I felt that it needed to be out of consent, and it was my mistake to put it in consent.
Okay. So I guess, can you give us a little...
We need a motion.
You need a motion to discuss that?
Mm-hmm. So move to discuss.
Mm-hmm. Second, I'll second it.
A motion made to discuss in a second.
We already have one here. Mm-hmm. We already have one with the pull out of that one.
Okay. Any questions? No. Go ahead, sir. Go ahead, Mr. Ramirez.
What was the question again? Because the reason, or is why am I here this evening? Is that what it is?
Well, can you tell us about the buses?
Okay. You all have a bar graph that I provided for you where it shows that 66 out of 100, we have 180, and these are just regular buses. This does not include the resource buses due to the fact that the resource buses, the oldest one is 2009, so they're in pretty decent shape. 66 out of 180, or 37% of our buses, are 11 years or older. 62 out of 180, 34%, 12 years and older. 51, 14 years and older, or 28%, and 36 out of 180, 20%, are 15 years or older. If you look at the, there was an item that I think was passed this evening about the 30 new buses coming in September. And 28 out of those 30 are regular buses and 2 are resource buses. I'm looking at the left-hand side of the bar graph, 1999 to 2001, where if you add 18, 7, 6, and 5, you get 36 buses. The 37 buses, or 38 buses that, including the 9 that are on this item, would pretty much offset, and we would use these buses as spares, because at this moment, we really don't have any spare buses. And here at La Jolla, for your information, we travel approximately 13,000 to 15,000 miles every day with our buses carrying our kids. And if any time a bus breaks down and we have 1 to 2 buses breaking down a day, it puts our students at safety, and that's our utmost responsibility, is to carry the students from to and from school every day in the best possible buses as possible.
So can you give us off the top of your head an average of what you're spending on a bus that has 6 or 7, 8, 9 years old to fix?
Well, let me go back to DPS. We called DPS and we asked them what's the longevity or what's the lifespan of a school bus. DPS quoted 10 to 12. We called International, the builder, And they said it depends. If your buses run on asphalt only, blacktop, that could last you 15 years. But if they don't, if they travel caliche roads, it could deteriorate the bus faster and reduce it to 10 or less. We called Region 1. Region 1 said about 15 years. And we also Googled, which said 12 to 15 years. But to get to your question, most of these buses, and I'm looking at 2008, those are the buses that are giving us more problems, but looking at, you have an estimate there of an overhaul of 14,000, that's one of the cheapest because they mostly run $14,000, $15,000, $16,000, $17,000, $18,000 to overhaul, and overhauls normally start after the 12th, 13th year.
How many buses break down averagely on a weekly basis?
Break down on the street?
Yeah.
One and a half a day, sir.
How many overhauls are we doing right now, a week?
We're looking probably at maybe once every 2 or 3 weeks, sir. But it's still, I'm looking at the 2000s, 1999s. They're in for pretty close to it. Because if you look also at the other page, you have what I call the...
I have no problem purchasing buses.
Bus obituary.
I have no problem purchasing buses. I know this board has been pretty much going in the direction of always providing air-conditioned buses for this, and I noticed that these don't have air condition on them.
Yes, sir, they don't. And we contacted Andy's Air, and they provided a quote for us, $7,500 per bus, and okay. They're looking at maybe even lowering it to maybe $7,000.
Which would mean that a bus that we purchased right now, adding the AC would be?
Approximately $69,000.
$69,000?
And brand new?
100, pretty much.
100,000?
Yes.
And these buses that are not going to have air condition, are they going to be used on short routes, or what's going to be the?
They'll be regular routes. We saw, and I took Mr. Martin Barrientos, he's here with me. We went to Oklahoma. We viewed these nine. There's 8 2000s and 1 2012. And the reason this company had them is that they leased them, and the school district gave them back because they liked them so much that they decided to buy buses. They have approximately 30,000 miles each one on the average in the odometer.
30,000 miles?
Yes, sir.
That's not too bad.
Okay, and the new ones are coming in when, Mr. Ramirez?
I'm projecting hopefully by the beginning of the year or no later than September.
So your reasoning behind using these that don't have the air conditioning, because I'm also looking at what Mr. Alanis is saying.
What?
Why is it important to go with this ones? Because we would have to wait, you know, and not have those 8 or 9 buses?
These 8, 9 buses, sir, would help us complete the school year, and I would ask for the board, with their permission, to add the air conditioning in the summer, where there's less movement with the buses.
So basically these 8 or 9 would be to alleviate the situation that you have with?
Yes, right now.
And these would come in when?
During spring break.
We can't get them sooner, the new buses?
Can
we get the new buses sooner?
2017s?
Well, the ones other agenda item that we approved 28 new buses.
We could try.
I mean, I'm for purchasing buses for the students. The thing is that if we're going to spend over $500,000 to alleviate a problem from here to the end of the year, you know, that's a lot of money. I'd rather wait a little bit and get new buses with air conditioning and everything.
But please understand that if we don't purchase these buses, we'll be using the 1998s. And they'll be, we're looking at close to 20-year-old bus.
Are you going to sell these other buses, those 99s? Are they going to go up for auction, or are they still going to be on the road?
I didn't hear.
Are you going to auction out these other ones, the ones you're going to, the 99s?
No, the 99s, but they would have, the ones that are available right now, they would be our spares.
Oh, okay. So you're saving approximately what, $30,000-$40,000 on each bus?
Come again, sir?
You're saving how much, $30,000-$40,000?
More or less, yes, sir. This is not a want, this is a need, gentlemen of the board, Madam Superintendent.
We're with you. We're just debating the issue of what is best, to get brand-new buses and get longer longevity, or get used buses. That's the only issue. It's not a debatable if it's a need or a want.
With the given circumstances that he has those issues, and I know because I've had two parents that have called me, the kids take longer to get from school to home and from home to school, so I'm gonna go ahead and make a motion for approval as it reads here.
Okay, I'm sorry. I have a motion made and a second for approval. Any questions? All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
All opposed? Motion passes. Thank you, Mr. Lemides.
Thank you, gentlemen.
Thank you, gentlemen.
Next item we have under business and finance, item number 6, standard form of agreement between owner and contractor for Sam Fordyce sanitary sewer line project.
I'll second.
I have a motion made and a second. Any questions? All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
All opposed? Motion passes. Item number 7, proposal submitted by engineering firm for assessment of the cracked exterior brick veneer at Jimmy Carter Early College High School.
Second.
I have a motion made and a second. Any questions? All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
All opposed? Motion passes. Item number 8, HVAC building controls for La Jolla ISD Jimmy Carter Early College High School through Choice Partners Purchasing Co-op.
So moved.
Second.
I have a motion made and a second. Any questions? All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
All opposed? Motion passes. Item number 9, change order number 1 for La Jolla ISD, Juarez Lincoln, and Palmview High School dugout enclosures.
So moved.
Second.
I have a motion made and a second. Any questions? All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
All opposed? Motion passes. Item number 10, ranking of competitive sealed proposals for the HVAC renovations project at Guillermo Flores Elementary School.
Second.
I have a motion made a second. Any questions? All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
All opposed? Motion passes. Item number 11, negotiate contract with contractor offering best value to the school district based on the published criteria and on ranking evaluation of competitive sealed proposals for the HVAC renovations project at Guillermo Flores Elementary School.
I'll second.
I have a motion made a second. Any questions? All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
All opposed? Motion passes. Item number 12, La Jolla ISD Energy Master Plan.
Also moved.
I have a motion made. Any second? Any questions? All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
All opposed? Motion passes. Item number 13, financing procurement of school buses, technology equipment, and telephone system.
So moved.
Second.
I have a motion made a second. Any questions? All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
All opposed? Motion passes. Item number 14, official district calendar for the 2016-17 school year.
So moved.
Second.
I have a motion made a second. Any questions? All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
All opposed? Motion passes. We'll now go into executive session at 6:51 p.m. under Texas Government Code 7551071, 072, and 074. Thank you. We're back from executive session at 7:50 p.m.
Mr. President, under letter H, under personnel, items 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, motion for approval is discussed in executive session.
Second.
I have a motion made a second. Any questions? All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
All opposed? Motion passes. Thank you. This meeting is now adjourned at 7:50 p.m.